Richard Diebenkorn is a famous American painter, well known for his abstract Ocean Park series. I will paint like Richard Diebenkorn, using elements of my hometown IJsselstein in the Netherlands to get to a composition. Just after this. Hi there, my name is Albert van der Zwart. Welcome to Imperfect Paintings, where it's all about improving your painting skills by looking at art, yourself and the world around you. One of my subscribers, Sharon, asked me a few weeks ago to do a video about Diebenkorn, an unknown painter for me. Sharon, thanks, I hope you like this video. I even bought this wonderful book about this Ocean Park series to help me. Link in the description below. Richard Diebenkorn is a famous American West Coast painter who lived from 1922 until 1993. I, being a lover of abstract painting, fell in love with his work. This painting is known as Ocean Park Series 27. What I see is color planes and white lines, as if he used masking tape to divide the colors. This dark blue line in the white is even more dominant. At the same time, you see this thin line. And in art, just as in anything, when you take a second look, you'll see more. Like for instance, these lines between the different colors of blue. Or in this one, you'll see lines he painted over. All these lines are nice, but how can you create an interesting composition when you want to paint like Richard Diebenkorn? My first reaction is building plan, or a map like this one of the Santa Monica Ocean Park area. I think I recognize the lines of this road in his painting. And these sketch line ones look like someone is designing things. This one has almost a three-dimensional, a figurative aspect. To create your own Diebenkorn style painting, you can copy the lines of one of his paintings. In my opinion, it's way more creative to find your own composition. Let me show you how I do it. I take the map of my hometown IJsselstein in the Netherlands and focus on the latest added neighborhood called Zender Park or Broadcast Park because of the giant broadcasting tower nearby. I see this interesting part here with a bend in the road and also these repeated lines. I also have a shot of a row of houses and this old church tower in our city center built in 1535 in the sun on the foggy first day of January this week. Happy New Year! Based on seeing these paintings, I tried out different options for my lines. So I took a charcoal stick, oil pastel, soft pastel, thick oily pencil, a normal pencil and a marker to see which one I could use for my lines. When I rub my finger through it, four of them create stains, not a good sign. And when using black paint, you don't see anything special. But when using transparent yellow, you can see clearly the problems they cause. Only the marker and the normal pencil can be used. But I don't like either, so I mix a gray, combine it with diluted acrylic medium gloss, and that will be my choice for my painting. Before painting the lines, I covered my whole sheet with white paint. This sheet is 65 by 65 centimeters. Unfortunately, it's 120 grams paper instead of the 200 grams I normally use, so it curled a bit. Let me show you how I combine elements to get to a composition. At this moment you can say, it's just a matter of choosing colors and paint the whole thing. It's not so interesting to look at in this case, so I jump through like this is a time lapse. Richard Diebenkorn worked with a limited palette of colors and mixed them in different versions. Like in this one, with all these variations of blue. Or in this one, where I don't know how to name all these colors, beige, yellow, orange perhaps. Somehow, my painting isn't a Richard Diebenkorn painting yet. So I looked on the internet. I would love to walk the streets of Ocean Park, Santa Monica, but I can't, so I virtually walked around and came across these photographs. Lovely ocean colors, interesting bike lane color, hotel, a house, a pool, and all linked to Ocean Park, Santa Monica. With these newfound colors in mind, I go back to Richard Diebenkorn. And as always, when I take a second look, I see new things. Here, half the painting is blue. Or here, mainly yellows. I now see that mine has too many colored pieces. So I create bigger planes of one color. The weather conditions over here are quite different at the moment. So I will add some grays too. I don't know if you think or feel the same about this. But for me, it brings more peace in this chaos. Because I work with transparent paint, you still see the previous colors through the next layer, just as in the Richard Diebenkorn paintings. A lot of his paintings are large pieces, like 250 by 200 centimeters, 100 by 80 inch, or 200 by 200 centimeters, 78 by 78 inch. Maybe this is a good moment to show you some other Richard Diebenkorn paintings. He also painted interesting portraits. Funny thing is, I especially like the background in these paintings. They look like the prelude to the Ocean Park series. You can see it is finished, but it doesn't feel so for me. And it is this green plane in the middle that bugs me. I remember the ocean colors and we'll see if this will solve the problem. What I like about making a Richard Diebenkorn style painting is that in the beginning it all looks so simple, but it turns out to be more complicated, as usual. This time it's a game of playing with your senses. Will the colors match or is one too dominant? In 18 years he completed some 135 paintings, so you can calculate he had over a month to finish one. That gives you a lot of time just sitting and looking to puzzle out the best compositions and color combination. When you take the time to look at his original paintings in a museum, you probably can figure out the steps of his process, like which color he used first. Unfortunately, I can't recall ever seeing one in a museum in the Netherlands. I would love to hear from which painter you would like to see a video about. Let's talk in the comments. I read and answer them all. Another painter I like is Charles d'Aubigny, a French landscape painter and a member of the Barbizon School of Painting. He likes to put some extra color in his skies. I went over to the museum to see a number of his paintings to be able to create a sunset over the ocean painting. Click on the link and I will see you over there in the next video.